channel. So today's video is a very exciting 4th of July theme video. So basically I'm going to be showing you a few DIY decor ideas and a few DIY snack ideas for your 4th of July party. If you're excited for this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up and let's go ahead and get into it. I hopped off the plane at LAX with a dream, my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame. So the first treat that I'm going to show you how to make are these flag strawberries. They're super easy to make. So basically all you have to do is get some strawberries. I used frozen strawberries because I thought that they'd be easier to cover in things since they'd be a little bit harder than soft strawberries. But I feel like normal strawberries would work fine too. And you're going to dip it into white icing and then go ahead and dip the tip of it into some blue sprinkles. And that is it. Seriously, it's so easy and so delicious. Side note, I think it'd be really fun if you can find them to use blue pop rocks instead of blue sprinkles, because I feel like pop rocks are like fireworks for your mouth, because like, you know, they like pop and stuff in your mouth. However, apparently those are not sold very many places anymore, so I couldn't find them. Sprinkles worked fine too, but I think pop rocks would be really fun. And then after that, you're gonna go ahead and keep them in the freezer until you're ready to eat them. And then you can take them out to your party and you're ready to go. These were so, so delicious. These were everyone's favorite snack from the party. And they're just like super sweet and yummy and delicious. Gotta be from out of town. So hard with my girls on around me. It's definitely not a Nashville party. Cause all I see is the lit up. I guess I never got the memo. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kind of homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the DJ. So to start off this next DIY treat, you're just going to go ahead and start separating your Oreos. So you're just going to take the top off of them. I got these ones from the dollar store and they were really wimpy on cream. I was sort of disappointed, but they were dollar store cookies, so what can you do? Am I right? So once you have those separated, you're going to need to go out and buy yourself some candy coating. This is the brand that I found at Target and it's vanilla flavored. You definitely want vanilla so that it's white. I know that they have another brand at Michael's, so you can use that as well. And then you're going to go ahead and follow the instructions on your packaging. It all depends on the brand, how you're going to make this work. Mine, you take this and you put it in the microwave for a minute, stir it, and then put it back in for 15 more seconds. And when you're done, your candy is going to be melted and ready to coat on top of whatever you want. In our case, Oreos. So as you can see, here it is all melted up. You can just melt it right in that same container, which I thought was really convenient. And then what you're going to do is take some on a spoon, add it to the cream part of your Oreo, and then you're going to take a popsicle stick, which I got at Target, and stick it in there, and then put the top back on, and then you can set it aside. And once you're finished doing this to all of your Oreos, you can stick it in the fridge to dry. You can also leave it out to dry, but if you want to make it go faster, obviously put it in the fridge or freezer. In the fridge, these took about 5 minutes to dry, so it does dry really, really quickly in the fridge. And I feel like out of the fridge, it would probably take 15 or 20 minutes to dry, so it all depends on how much of a rush you're in. Once you're finished doing that to all of your Oreo Pops, you can go ahead and stick that in the fridge for 5 minutes and wait for them to be ready to go. And when they come out, you should be able to pick up the Oreos by the sticks without like worrying about the Oreo falling off. So now we're going to go back to the candy coating, and this time we're going to cover the entire Oreo in the candy. I know guys, a little bit crazy, but it is delicious. This stuff is so good. So you can go ahead and use a spoon to help cover the Oreo with the candy coating if that makes it a little bit easier. And then you're going to put it down on a plate, and then when you're finished covering all of them, you can go ahead and stick this in the refrigerator for about 15 minutes to dry. It takes a little bit longer because there's more candy. If you're worried about what plate to put it on, I definitely recommend putting it on like a porcelain plate or a glass plate or something like that, because it does harden to the plate, but when you use something like the plate that I'm using, you can pull it off. But I feel like on a paper plate, the paper might get stuck to it, which would be an issue. So since this is a 4th of July video, I decided that I better do some blue and red ones as well. So I just put some into a bowl and added some blue food coloring. And now I'm going to go ahead and cover some more of my Oreo Pops in blue and then in red. My red came out a little bit more pink than red, but you know what? You do what you can with the food coloring, am I right? And once mine were all done drying in the refrigerator, I just went ahead and added some random designs to it using the leftover pink that I had. I just used a little popsicle stick and added some polka dots and some stripes because I thought it would make it a little bit more fun and exciting. And after you're finished laying your designs dry, you are good to go. These are so yummy. They're super sweet, so definitely heads up about that, because they are definitely for those of you out there who have a sweet tooth like me. But they are delicious, and your friends will love them too. All my friends had a great time eating them because they were so good. And you can do all sorts of designs and colors, which is always really fun. You can specialize it depending on what your party is. So if you're watching this after the 4th of July, do not fret. You can make these for fun or for a different party. First DIY decor is going to be this patriotic lantern, which just looks really cute on a table wherever you keep your treats. So you're going to start by taking a mason jar and removing the lid, and then you're going to want to pour some white rice into it as high as you're going to want your rice to be. So measure it out exactly the way that you want it before you move on to the next step. Then what you're going to do is separate out 1/3 of your mason jar into one bowl and 1/3 of the mason jar into the other bowl, and you're going to do that with however many mason jars you have. Basically, you just want to separate it so that you have 1/3 white, 1/3 red, and 1/3 blue. Now comes the fun part, the food coloring. So I just went ahead and put some red food coloring into one bowl and started mixing up. And this attaches to the rice really well. I was a little worried about how this might work, but it dyes it perfectly. And as you can see, it does a pretty good job of getting all the rice. There's still some white rice in there, but you get the general gist. And if you keep adding food coloring, eventually you will get all of them to be colored red. And then I just repeated the same exact thing, except with blue in the other bowl. That way we would have red, white, and blue rice. Everything in between. I wanna buy any part out of it. So then I just used a spoon and started to add back in the rice. So as you can see, started with red, then I poured in the white, and then the blue. Pretty self-explanatory the way that you can go about doing this, but once you are done with that, the last thing to do is add in your tea light. So I just have normal old tea lights, and I just went ahead and snuggled one in there and made sure the rice was sort of all around it nice and tightly, and then you are good to go. And you can obviously also use an electric candle if you don't want to use a real tea light, totally up to you. It was a little windy when I was filming, so I couldn't get my tea light to stay lit, but it will work, I promise. Just maybe it'll go out if it's a little windy outside. Every day is a competition. Put the key. So I wanted to show you another way that you can decorate your table. Once again, incredibly easy. So I just got these 3 glass vases from the dollar store, so super inexpensive and cost efficient. And you're going to go ahead and add water to all 3 of them, and then you're going to put red food dye in one of them and blue in the other and leave one plain, and then you have red, white, and blue water. Pretty clever, right? I just went ahead and used one of those popsicle sticks from earlier to mix this up, but I thought they looked really cool when you first add the food coloring in there. How it sort of was like melty and cool. I just thought that was really awesome. And then I went and got some fake flowers once again from the dollar store, so super cost efficient. I got white ones to go in the red and blue vase, and then I actually found red, white, and blue flowers to go in the white one. That way it would add a little bit more color to the white one, since I figured the other ones get their own little bits of color. And that is it for this DIY. Pretty much one of the easiest ever, because all you're doing is adding food coloring to water and sticking flowers in it. And you can definitely use fresh flowers if you want to. I just thought fake flowers would be easier because you can reuse them later for a different DIY. Stripe flag wrapped around my head, blue, white, little bit of red. Live free like we always said, oh, whoa-oh. And lastly, I have an outfit idea for the 4th of July. So I just went with something really simple. I got this t-shirt from Target for $6 because I didn't have anything red to wear and I thought that I needed to. And my skirt is from American Apparel and my shoes are from Shoe Dazzle. And then I wanted to get some blue in there. So to top it all off, I added a little blue bandana in my hair as a hair tie. I always think tying a bandana in your hair is super America-like. So I always think that that's really good for like Memorial Day and the 4th of July and Labor Day and stuff like that. This is just a really simple summery outfit. I want something that would be comfortable and easy to hang out with my friends in, because obviously you don't want to feel uncomfortable in whatever you're wearing at your party. today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And a big thank you to all of my friends for being in this video. I'm going to make sure to link all of their social media right down there, so go check them out. Also, if you want to see some behind-the-scenes stuff from filming this video, it was a little ridiculous, and I got it all on my vlogs, make sure that you check out my vlog channel. And while you're down there in the description, why don't you go ahead and check me out on all my social media. That's Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, all that good stuff is linked right down there. I love you all so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye!
Hey, what's going on?
They're having a competition who can do it the longest. It's a little ridiculous.
Ah!
Jill's a singer.
Oh, God.
Oh, Jesus. This isn't even fun anymore, cheater.